Sweet delay. Well, let an evil lie, so they say, but I'll hide from the devil on judgment day. I say, I'm a fire, I'm old man. I'm a fire, I'm old man. I'm a fire, I'm old man down the line. Oh, yeah. Well, me and the devil setting out a stop line. He started rolling all us out of sight. I say, I'm a fire, I'm old man. I'm on fire, I'm on man. I'm on fire, I'm on man on the line. Oh, yeah. Well, going pretty fast, I look behind. I hear the devil doing 99. I'm saying, I'm on fire, I'm on man. I'm on fire, I'm on man. I'm on fire, I'm on man on the line.
Let's drag now!
Hey everyone, Joe here. Just wanted to do a update, a quick update on the cancer awareness group build. We're doing the 51 Chevy Bel Air. We got a few things done, but not too much because we just kind of started it. The first thing we got, and you'll notice we got a different camera angle right now, and that's because we're going to show you guys something that I don't normally do. But first thing we got, let's try and get it in the screen here, is our engine block. Put together and done, and just to get some more light on it for you guys. This is kind of an odd color, and I'll explain why. It's because it's a grayish blue, and the reason for that is the Chevy engines were this grayish blue up until 1952, and then they became the Chevy blue that you all might notice. But this is an odd color. It's really difficult to find, so we just had to kind of go with what we saw in reference photos, and I'm going to pop that up here in the corner. And so in our reference photos, basically the closest thing that we could find that actually worked out really well was field blue from Tamiya. And so over a gray primer, it turned out to be almost spot on, I think. And so we got that together and painted up, and we've also got our transmission done and painted up. And what we've done with that is, that's just to me is titanium silver over no primer. And then we just panel washed it and started taking the panel wash off a little bit. And then the only other thing I have is I've been sanding the body and prepping that. But I wanted to show you all something. It might be useful, it may not be. A while ago, a few months ago, back in July for my birthday, I got a present. And it was these God Hand chisel set. It's not a cheap present. I think they're about $40, and they come in different sizes. And you might say, well, I'm not real sure what I'd ever use these for, but what I got them for and what they're great at, and I'll show you, are the raised injector pin marks that are on a lot of our kits, right? So you can kind of see them there. Well, the blue napkin's kind of giving some lines and everything, but you can kind of see we've got raised injector pin marks. Now, I could sit there and sand them, or I could try and scrape them with my hobby knife, and I'll most likely scar something or cut my finger, which happens a lot. So what you can use these for is you just take these chisels, and I gotta put my goggles on and lean down here, and you can just start scraping it, and it follows it very well. They're very sharp. Instead of all that time sanding, make sure I'm in here, you just scrape out that plastic. That one's not bad. Follows along really nice.
so that they're really sharp, so they don't really gouge too much of the plastic away. It keeps you flat and lined up.
And takes them all down. I would have spent easily an hour trying to get those out with the knife, and now I can just go back in and sand them a little bit, and you can come in from all angles. So if I wanted to make sure we got that one here, because that's lifted up a little bit. And there you go. And we'll do it on, you know, the roof of this as well, because we have the you guys can't see them, but they're there. They're very large raised pin injections that are here. You could just take this and scrape it down. If not the whole thing, at least the edges, right? And then you can sand from there. But again, I've used this on a few things now, and it is, to me, invaluable. I mean, if you really want to clean up these pin injector marks and not spend hours and hours trying to sand or cut away with the hobby knife, to me, this is perfect. So I think there's other ones out there too. I can't vouch for them, but I know these God Hands, and we all know God Hand makes just fantastic tools. They're just really pricey. But if you get a chance, save some money, run out, get some of these. And that's really all I have so far for the update. So I hope you all are doing well and staying safe. And until next time. Take care.
Thought I was smart, the race was won. I come the devil doing 101. I'm a fire driving move man. I'm a fire driving move man. I'm a fire driving move man.